कुंती उवाच नमस्ये पुरुषं त्वाद्यं ईश्वरं प्रकृते परं अलक्ष्यं सर्वभूतानां अन्तर्बहिरवस्थितं मायाजवनिकाच्छन्नं अज्ञादोक्षजमव्ययम् न लक्ष्यसे मूढदृशा नटो नाट्यतरो यथा तथा परमहंसानां मुनीनामलात्मनां भक्तियोगविधानार्थं कथं पश्येमहिं स्त्रिया कृष्णाय वासुदेवाय देवकी नंदनाय च नंदगोपकुमाराय गोविंदाय नमो नमः नमः पंकजनाभाय नमः पंकजमालिने नमः पंकजनेत्राय नमस्ते पंकजांग्रये यथा ऋषिकेशखलेन देवकी कंसेन रुद्रातिचिरं शुचार्पिता विमोचिताहं च सहात्मजा विभो त्वय्येव नाथेन मुहुर्विपद्गणा विषान्महाग्ने पुरुषाददर्शना असत्सभाया वनवासकृच्छता मृदे मृदे नेकमहारथाश्वतो द्रोण्यस्त्रतश्चास्म हरेभिरक्षिता विपदा सन्तु ता शश्वत तत्र तत्र जगद्गुरो भवतो दर्शनं यत्स्यादपुनर्भवदर्शनं जन्मैश्वर्यश्रुतश्रीभिः एदमानमद पुमान् नैवाहर्त्यभिधातुं वै त्वामकिञ्चन गोचरम् नमो किंचन वित्ताय निवृत गुणवृत्तये आत्मा रामाय शांताय कैवल्यपतये नमः मन्ये त्वां कालमीशानं अनादि निधनं विभुं समं चरन्तं सर्वत्र भूतानां यन्मिथकली न वेद कश्चित् भगवांश्चिकीर्षितां तवेहमानस्य नृणां विडम्बनं न यस्य कश्चित् दयितोऽस्ति कर्हिचित् द्वेष्यश्च यस्मिन् विषमा मतिर्नृणा जन्म कर्म च विश्वात्मन् अजस्य कर्तुरात्मना तिर्यन् ऋषिषु यादस्सु तद् अत्यन्त विडम्बनम् गोप्या ददे त्वयि कृता गजिदामताव याते दशाश्रुकलिलाञ्जनसम्भ्रमाक्षं वक्त्रं निनीय भयभावनया स्थितस्य सामां विमोहयति भीर अपि यद् बिभेति केचिदाहुरजं जातं पुण्यश्लोकस्य कीर्तये यदो प्रियस्य अन्ववाये मलयस्येव चन्दनम् अपरे वसुदेवस्य देवक्यां याचितोऽभ्यगात् अजस्त्वमस्य क्षेमाय वधाय च सुरद्विषाम् भारावतारणायान्ये भुवो नाव इवो दधो सीदन्त्या भूरिभारेण जातो ह्यात्मभुवार्थिता भवेस्मिन् क्लिश्यमानानां अविद्या कामकर्मभिः श्रवणस्मरणर्हाणि करिष्यन् इति केचन शृण्वन्ति गायन्ति गृह्णन्त्यभिक्ष्णशः स्मरन्ति नन्दन्ति तवेहितं जनाः त एव पश्यन्त्यचिरेण तावकम् भवप्रवाहो परमं पदाम्बुजम् अप्यत्यनस्त्वं स्वकृते हित प्रभो जिहाससि स्वित्सुहृदोऽनुजीविना येषां न चान्यत् भवता पदाम्बुजा परायणं राजसुयोजितं हसां केवयं नामरूपाभ्यां यदुभिः सह पाण्डवाः भवतो दर्शनं यर्हि ऋषिकानामिवेशितु नेयं शोभिष्यते तत्र यथेदानीं गदाधर त्वदपदेरङ्किता भाति स्वलक्षणविलक्षितैः इमे जनपदाश्रिताः सुपक्वौषधिवीरुडा वनाद्रिनद्युदन्वन्तो ये दन्ते तव वीक्षितै अथ विश्वेश विश्वात्मन् विश्वमूर्ते स्वकेषु मे स्नेहपाशमिमं छिन्दि दृढं पाण्डुषु वृष्णिषु त्वयि मे नन्यविषया मतिर्मदुपते सकृत् रतिम् उद्वहता दद्धा गङ्गे वोगं मुदन्वती श्रीकृष्ण कृष्ण सखवृष्णिषभावनिदृ राजन्यवंशदहनानपवर्गवीर्य गोविन्द गोद्विजसुरार्तिहरावतार योगेश्वराखिलगुरो भगवन् नमस्ते हरे कृष्णा 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 हरे 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 राम 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 हरे हरे राम राम हरे हरे राम राम the tragic, heroic, and a legendary figure of Queen Kunti emerges from an explosive era in the history of ancient India. Queen Kunti was the wife of the great King Pandu, mother of the five illustrious brothers, the Pandavas, sister of King Vasudev, and the aunt of Lord Krishna. She was a great devotee of Lord Krishna, and through the trials and difficulties that she underwent in her life, she has taught us how to maintain our loyalty, chastity, and devotion for the Lord under any situations of life. Her faith and dedication for the Lord was undeterred, even though she was tested many times. Driven by uncontrollable envy, Duryodhan plotted against the Pandavas and inflicted many sufferings upon them. He made several attempts to kill the Pandavas. All the while, the five youthful Pandavas were accompanied by their courageous mother Kunti, who suffered Duryodhan's atrocities in the company of her beloved sons. Miraculously, however, Kunti and the Pandavas repeatedly escaped death, for they were under the loving protection of Lord Shri Krishna, who had incarnated to perform his earthly pastimes. Lord Krishna protected the Pandavas and their mother Kunti from imminent death by stopping the weapon's uncontrollable heat and radiation with his own Sudarshan Chakra. Having delivered the Pandavas from this last calamity and seeing that all his plans were fulfilled, Lord Krishna now was preparing to leave for his majestic capital city Dwarka. For years, Duryodhan had tormented Queen Kunti's family, but Krishna had protected them at every step of life. And now he was going away. Kunti was overwhelmed, and she prayed to Krishna from the core of her heart. The scene of Lord's imminent departure provides the setting for Queen Kunti's exalted prayers. Kunti approached the Lord's chariot and began to address him. "O my Lord, are you leaving us today? Though we are completely dependent on your mercy and have no one else to protect us, now when all the kings are at enmity with us?" From this supplication, we should not mistakenly conclude that Kunti's prayers were self-serving. Although her sufferings were far greater than those any ordinary person could endure, she does not beg relief. On the contrary, she prays to suffer even more, for she reasons that her suffering will increase her devotion to the Lord and bring her ultimate liberation. We don't think anyone on this planet Earth in their dreams would ever ask for even one trial, one tragedy, one trauma, one misfortune, or any adversity in their lives. On the contrary, our daily prayers to the Lord is to please keep us protected. And here we have Kunti Maharani, who is not only welcoming all the calamities but also begging the Lord to bestow them on her over and over again. She does not ask for relief, but she is asking for the ultimate release from the cycle of birth and death. Kunti's words reveal both the deepest transcendental emotions of heart and the most profound philosophical and theological penetrations of the intellect. Her words are the words of glorification, impelled by a divine love, steeped in wisdom. O Lord of Madhu, as the Ganges forever flows to the sea without hindrance, let my attraction be constantly drawn unto you without being diverted to anyone else. Kunti's spontaneous glorification of Lord Krishna and her description of the spiritual path are immortalized in the Mahabharata and the Bhagavad Puran, and they have been recited, chanted, and sung by sages and philosophers for thousands and thousands of years. As they appear in the first canto of Srimad Bhagavatam, Queen Kunti's celebrated prayers consist of only 26 couplets, yet they are considered a philosophical, theological, and literary masterpiece. Let us imbibe her mood of glorifying Lord Krishna. Let us make him our only object of love. Let us make him our only refuge. Let us make him our only goal in life. Let us make him our only attraction without being diverted to anyone else, as exemplified by Kunti Devi in her prayers unto Lord Shri Krishna.